we'll talk to a lot of folks and they'll say, oh, I got my bill for Snowflake. I'm not sure why it is what it is, and I don't really understand what's going on. These are all the things that we need to understand and be aware of with what's going on in our Snowflake data cloud.
If you think about it, charges for a Snowflake account divide it into maybe three main categories, if you will. The first one is credit and credit consumption. Credits are equivalent to compute. We use credits for compute capabilities. So when you hear about t-shirt sizes, extra small, large, 4XL, and so on, all of those are related to your credit consumption. The other part of this is storage. Storage is divided into a couple of different things. There's active storage. This is real data. This is data that's compressed that Snowflake has access to and you're able to query against. But the other types of storage is time travel and fail-safe and clone retention and stage layer. So all of those also add up into your storage costs. Time travel and fail-safe can be a big surprise to people, especially if they don't understand how Snowflake works. Different kinds of tables, transient tables versus permanent tables, will treat time travel differently. And so we've seen when Intricity is brought in to do a health check, we've seen a lot of times where storage has been a runaway cost and people don't necessarily understand why. One of the big drivers there is your settings around time travel, the way that you're using transient tables, your clone retention policies, all of those kinds of things become really, really important and impact your storage costs. The third big component of cost is cloud services. So when you authenticate, when you manage your infrastructure, when you do look at queries history, when you operate on the access control side of things, those are cloud services. For small accounts, you may not even see this cost in your account. For large accounts or those that do things that are not expected, not normal, we have a customer that does a lot of show commands on their schema. So that can impact your cloud layer cost. So we've got compute, we've got storage, we've got metadata. Those are the three primary ones that I think are important to understand.
Hey folks, thanks for checking out this cut from our broadcast. To see the full show, click on the link in the video description. Also, check out our Learning Center, which has white papers, events, live streams, and short explainer videos on a wide range of data management topics. And of course, if you like our content, please share it on LinkedIn. That really means a lot to us. Thanks again for checking us out, and we hope to see you in our next broadcast.